Over 3,500 years ago, it was first documented on Egyptian papyrus. Historical Indian texts termed it as honey urine, while the ancient Chinese called it wasting thirst. But in our modern era, most people would know it as diabetes mellitus, a disease linked to high blood glucose. It is a lifelong condition that is still on the rise, with at least 460 million people worldwide living with it in 2019. How did our understanding of it evolve through time? What breakthroughs have impacted the way we see, treat, and research diabetes now? The term diabetes was thought to be coined by a Greek physician around 300 BC. It was derived from the Greek word meaning to siphon, which references the notable symptoms of constant thirst and frequent urination of the condition. Over the next 2,000 years, physicians started to develop a better understanding of diabetes in identifying and treating it. Even up till the late 19th century, varying methods of treatment were devised, mainly consisting of dietary changes, for example, the oat cure, potato therapy, milk diet, and etc., but still inevitably led to the premature death of a lot of people. So what made a difference? In 1889, Oskar Minkowski and Joseph von Mehring first made a vital link when they removed pancreases from dogs and observed the onset of diabetic symptoms and death soon after. This was a milestone in identifying the role of the pancreas in the regulation of blood glucose. While Paul Langerhans was the first to describe the cell types of the pancreas, their function was then still unknown, but only in the early 1900s was then insulin proposed as a name for a chemical secreted by these islets of Langerhans. After a series of experiments involving pancreatic secretions, Frederick Banting and Charles Best introduced an isolated secretion into dogs with diabetes. The significant drop in blood glucose levels that followed marked the breakthrough of insulin in diabetes treatment. With the help of John McLeod and James Collip, further research in the extraction and purification of insulin from adult cow pancreases was made possible. History was then made when Leonard Thompson became the first diabetic patient to receive insulin. For their revolutionary work, Banting and McLeod were awarded the 1923 Nobel Prize in Medicine, sharing prize earnings with Best and Collip. Thus, insulin mass production kicked off with extracts purified from animal tissue. On the diagnostic side, a dip and read urine test was developed in the 1940s and was innovated in later years to give better accuracy, using a single drop of blood instead. In 1957, results from a study on the effectiveness of the drug metformin in reducing blood sugar levels were published. It was marketed as glucophage and was first introduced in France, and has since become the first-line drug to treat and to help to prevent type 2 diabetes. Soon after, Frederick Sanger uncovered the primary structure of insulin and was awarded the 1958 Nobel Prize in Chemistry. In 1966, the first pancreas transplantation in an attempt to cure type 1 diabetes was done in Minnesota of the United States. Another testing breakthrough was then made in 1971 when the first glucose meter was developed, utilizing blood glucose test strips to quantify blood sugar levels. As a commercial product, self-monitoring of blood glucose had become convenient and accurate. In 1976, Dean Kamen innovated the insulin pump, making it a portable device that delivers insulin periodically into the body of patients with diabetes. Just 2 years later, Humulin, the first human-based form of insulin, was synthetically made by Genentech and took another 4 years to hit the shelves, and thus, animal tissue stockpiling was eliminated. In fact, more insulin analogs were produced and clinically approved in the decades that followed. In more or less 100 years, we have not only vastly improved our understanding of diabetes, but also developed cutting-edge technology to pave the way for better diagnostics and treatment. From first unraveling the mechanisms of diabetes and insulin to innovating glucose meters and insulin pumps, all this has greatly improved the quality of life of many diabetics. But what does the future hold for diabetes? Just recently in 2016, the Medtronic MiniMed became the first clinically approved closed-loop system as an artificial pancreas. It can sense one's insulin basal needs and adjust insulin delivery accordingly, and thus effectively mimic an actual pancreas. Nevertheless, research continues in search for the magic bullet in curing diabetes, with work such as islet cell transplantation and improved bionic pancreases done in collaboration by scientists in the field. We can only hope to see what the future has in store for diabetes, as many wait to savour a truly sweet victory.